Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, please forgive me, but I have to take care of a personal matter. Enjoy your dinner. Edmund, please.
Thank you.
Well, last night, I wanted it to be just the two of us. Edna, these last 10 days have... You have changed my life.
It has been wonderful.
I have something to ask you.
Oh, gosh.
Will you?
Oh, goodness.
Will you go with me on another cruise?
Oh, a cruise? Why, sure. Yes. Oh, I'm vibrating.
Me too.
Oh, no, no. It's my palm pilot. Would you excuse me? I have to email my son, Raymond. Tell him what time we're talking.
You're an amazing woman, Edna Garrett. Tell me more fascinating stories.
Oh, I don't know. What's left to tell? After the Peace Corps in Senegal, Bruce and I traveled all over Africa and Asia and India. After Bruce passed, I felt lost for the first time. You see, Bruce was my home, and I didn't know where home was anymore. Then I got a message from my girls. I remembered where I belonged.
Your daughters. I want to hear all about them.
They're not my daughters, but they are my girls. We're always in touch. But we haven't all been in the same place at the same time for years. Well, everyone's so busy with their careers, their families, their travels. Well, this year, we got lucky. We're gonna have a good old-fashioned Eastland Thanksgiving.
That was so beautiful. Ah. Isn't it wonderful to be here today with this fantastic couple? Thank you so much for being so willing to share your story with us. What an amazing triumph. Unfortunately, you guys were out of time. Listen, next week, we're going to be rerunning your favorite episodes. So until then, thanks for joining us. And remember, wake up with Dorothy when?
Every day, LA.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah, the gynecology monologues,
oh,
right?
You know perfectly well what it's called.
Did I mention I think it's a terrible career move?
I'm not asking your opinion.
Can you sign this?
I have a flight tonight. I need an answer.
Yeah, well, your contract is up for renewal with rehearsals and a 3-week run. That's a month away from LA, right? Last time I checked, you were the host of a daily talk show.
Can you sign this?
Look, last time I checked, I was an actress. Donald, listen. I want to do this play. I need to do this play.
Yeah, okay. Hey, Dorothy. I'm from the theater too, okay? A lot of us are. And we all came out here for the same reason. Work. You know? The kind of work you actually get paid for? Someone tells me you didn't get this sweet ride by doing some highbrow experimental piece
of... Enough! Hello!
Sweetie?
Do not call me sweetie.
Dorothy, please, take a break. Go to Poughkeepsie.
Peekskill,
Poughkeepsie, Pookapoo, whatever. Just go, see your friends, have fun, and come back ready to do what you do best. Talk!
Hey, yo, can you please sign this?
Don't hey, yo, your mother.
Yeah, okay, whatever.
Honey, how do you think you're gonna get into college with grades like this?
Mom, I'm in the sixth grade.
I'd have sent you to your grandmother's instead of coming to New York with me. She would make you study.
No way. I'm not missing out on seeing Aunt Nat and everybody.
Yeah, well, Aunt Nat would kick your butt if she saw this report card. Come on, get in. We got packing to do.
Rascal, I see you. Yes, I do. I'm gonna get you. Yes, I am. I got you. Phew.
It's blonde. Well, I'd say it was blonde. Very, very blonde. Almost platinum. One might even call it gray. Oh, no. Twins.
Good morning, my pet.
Tad, darling, I have terrible news.
Ouch, me too.
You first.
No, you.
Guess.
All right. Donald Trump outbid us for the Woolworth building.
No.
The housekeeping staff is threatening to strike again.
Worse.
The hotel's on fire?
I found a gray hair.
Ooh, my, that is bad.
I'm too rich to get old.
Huh? It's like my father said when he hit his first 100 million. If you gotta get old, you may as well be rich. Angel. You get more beautiful every day. I can't wait to grow old with you.
Oh, Ted. You always know just what to say.
Mm.
It's your turn. What's your bad news?
I have to stay in the city.
Why?
The Soho acquisition. The negotiations are getting a little sticky.
That's why you married your attorney. Shall I rip them a new subpoena?
No, I'll handle it. I wouldn't ask you to miss one second with your friends. I'll wrap it up quickly. You go have fun. I'll join you tomorrow night.
Promise?
Promise. Provided you do something about this hair. It's embarrassing. Oh!
Lose my number. I don't care. I've cut the Putin piece to perfection and I'm done.
Excuse me, can you turn that down? I'm on the phone.
And why aren't we moving?
New York traffic. It's bad. Everywhere.
Try 60th? Oh, don't guilt trip me, Peter. I've been on the road for 5 months. I have no intention whatsoever of walking back into that building, let alone turning on a television for the next 7 days. This reunion is locked. These women are my friends. I haven't seen two of them for 5 years. Find another patsy, Peter. Happy turkey. Why are we going to the FDR? We need to be on the west side.
FDR is the best way.
Why do you cabbies always say that, the best way? I know the best way.
Oh, yeah. Big talking lady. Fancy purple cell phone. Know everything, lady. You think you can do better? A goddess. Let me pay you the fare.
No, that's okay, really.
I insist. You have opened my eyes and shown me a new light.
Okay.
You call that a tip?
Natalie?
Raymond?
Mate!
Momo, how are you?
I'm terrific. How are you, Miss TV news producer?
Thrilled to be here. How's your globe-trotting mom?
No, same as ever. She kissed me 99 times, talked nonstop from Manhattan, left me with the luggage, and ran off to town.
I'm so glad you could join us for the reunion.
Oh, I come with the hotel. I'm the executive manager.
No more accounting. You're kidding.
No, he's not. We decided if we were going to open an inn at Peekskill, then we must keep it all in the Eastland family.
Hi, Blair.
Natalie. Oh, watch the feathers. Watch the feathers.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it's so good to see you.
You look fantastic.
Oh, thank you. I think so, too.
A cozy little country inn, right. More like Blair Sigh.
What can I say?
Is Tootie here yet?
No, and she should be any minute. Raymond, I trust all the rooms are ready?
Yes. All except room 18, the leak in the ceiling has returned.
You're kidding. I thought Carl fixed that.
He quit.
Please tell me you're joking.
No, LA again.
Ever since George left, we've had 10 handyman ditches to go seek their fame and fortune in Hollywood. It is so irritating.
It is so irritating.
S'il vous plaît. S'il vous plaît. S'il vous plaît. S'il vous plaît. I ask for cumin. They give me coriander. I cannot work this way.
All right, all right. Don't flip your flan. I'll take care of it.
No, just fix it. Tout de suite. Allez, allez. Allez!
I'm leaving.
That's Chef Gauguin. We stole him from the George Sank when we were in Paris.
Seems a little high-strung.
Well, there is a rumor that Gourmet Magazine is sending an anonymous critic to review our little restaurant. So he's a bit anxious. Raymond, make sure Chef gets his cumin and see what you can do about that leak. I believe Carl's toolbox is in the cabinet. Oh, thank you, Sam.
Tools.
Blair! Natalie!
Tootie, it's really you!
Oh, come on now, you said you'd try.
Oh, Dorothy, I'm totally trying. Old habits die hard.
Honey, it's so good to see you up close and personal.
So good to be in the same time zone with you. Oh, look at this one. Come here, beautiful girl, give your tontonette a hug.
Dorothy, you look fabulous.
I want in.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, have you guys been to school yet?
Oh, no, I'm dying to. This will be the last chance we get to see our Eastland.
I think we should hit it.
Oh, shotgun.
Ah, girls, one cannot run in Manolo Blahniks.
You can't run at all.
Swam was on the track team.
It is so sad they're tearing this place down.
Criminal.
If I had sold it, the new building would be named after me.
Ah, oh, you guys, it's been so long. Look at this place.
It smells exactly the same.
It does!
Hey, let's go to the cafeteria.
Wait for me. I wonder if we'll run into Mr. Parker.
I wonder if Roy is still pining for Joe.
Hey, I wonder if these are still fitting my uniform.
Oh. Oh, my gosh. I can't believe it's been 15 years.
I can't believe that they got rid of the payphone.
I can't believe I used to do dishes.
You used to do windows, too. Oh, hello, girl.
Hey, this is Garrett.
Garrett. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, oh, look at you.
When did you get here?
Well, just a little while ago. I stopped at the inn, but I knew somehow you'd all come up here. Oh, there she is. Oh, Tisha, I haven't seen you since you were a little baby.
Hi, Mrs. Garrett.
My goodness. Oh. She's even more beautiful than her JPEG file. So where's Joe?
Not here yet.
Oh, let's not get our knickers in a twist. She'll be here.
Excuse me, little fella. Why don't you wipe your feet?
Who are you calling fella? Fella? What's everybody staring at? Jamie! Hiya, Blair.
Jamie, you certainly are your mother's daughter.
Oh, incoming.
Honey, you remember Jamie?
So,
nothing much. My dad's parking the bike.
Well, where's your mom?
L.A.,
What?
Why?
Well, I know the detour on the Major Deegan is confusing, but that's ridiculous.
Now, Joe's really, really sorry. But she and another cop from her division left last night to take a witness to testify at a mob trial.
But I haven't seen her for a lifetime.
I have a favor to ask you guys. I got an offer this morning to do a couple of tracks on the Backstreet Boys' new album. And I was wondering how Jamie's aunts would feel about watching her while I'm gone.
We'd love to!
Are you sure?
Of course.
Okay. I'm gonna go. You stay, and I'll see you in a couple of days. Okay?
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Who are the Backstairs Boys?
And this is Mahogany Room, our bar slash lounge. It's actually made of oak, but we changed the name. Oak is so déclassé. Ah!
My bad.
We get some wonderful cabaret acts from New York. We had Rachel Sidney here just last month.
Oh, my God.
Well, she's just so-so, actually.
Now my boyfriend's here.
Robert.
Could be.
Well, whatever his name is, I'll go help him.
I thought your boyfriend's name was Robert.
There is a Robert, and there's a Harper.
Natalie, you strumpet.
Oh, it's not like that.
Oh, it so is.
Oh, be quiet.
So, how did this little web of intrigue begin, pray tell?
Well, when I met Robert, he really knocked me out. But then a couple months later, they assigned me this amazing new cameraman, Harper. And we spent so much time on the road together that we kind of fell in like.
Do they know about each other?
They do.
Right?
You told me they do!
They do. They totally do. In the beginning, they were dating other people. I was dating other people. Nothing exclusive. But lately, things have kind of gotten serious. With both of them. Oh, he's just so great. I want you girls to meet him.
Honey?
Matt!
What are you doing here?
Oh, it's so good to see you. Mwah. Listen, don't kill me, all right? But I took the week off. Now, you've been gone so long, and I missed you so much, I just wanted to see you again. Now, look, I know you've got your reunion, so I'm gonna lay low, all right? You won't even know I'm here, all right? Unless I need someone to read me a little Colette around bedtime, eh, love pumpkin?
Ah, love pumpkin. Oh. You gonna hook your sisters up?
Robert James, this is Dorothy Ramsey.
Hi, it's a pleasure. I've heard so much about you.
How do you do?
Oh, and this is Blair Warner.
How do you do? How do you do?
She married a man with the same last name.
Saves on monograms.
Oh, Chante!
So, I don't mean to offend Blair or Dorothy here, but where is this remarkable Tootie you keep going on about?
Hey, I'm Tootie.
Tootie, Dorothy. Well, whoever you are, I feel like I know you.
Yeah.
Well, I really feel like a hot shower now. Do you think I could just check in my room for a bit?
Of course, just a minute. Raymond?
Yeah? Oh. Sam! Sam! Where's the bellboy? All right. I'll take you.
Very good. I'll see you in a bit.
Okay.
After I get my bag.
And Raymond, while you're up there, make sure the windows in 21 aren't sticking.
I'll try my hand at spackling, too, just for fun.
Well, that certainly was a surprise.
Surprise!
Harper?
Girls, it's Harper.
Hello.
Mrs. Garrett, this is my boyfriend.
I know. Rah.
Harper!
Rah, rah, rah. Sis boom ba. Attaboy, attaboy, rah, rah, rah.
Thank you.
Hi. I'm the remarkable Tootie that she's always going on about. Call me Dorothy.
Hello, Dorothy.
I'm the remarkable Blair. Call me remarkable.
Hey, Blair. It's great to meet you. Now listen, I hope you don't mind surprises, but once the general and his rebels surrendered, there was no story, so Copeland told me to come home and surprise someone I love. And that, babe, is you.
Wow. Wow.
I'm gonna check in.
Hello?
Yeah, we sure do. Well, I can't leave the desk right now, Mr. James. Can you come down? Great.
Who's coming where?
Mr. James forgot his toothbrush. We have extras.
Harper, you know, let's go for a walk.
Great. Just let me dump my stuff. I'll need a room, please.
You're lucky. There's only one room left. Need help with your bags?
No, I travel light. Back in a sec, babe.
Okay.
I'm not even here.
On the move, babe!
I'm all set. Take me on the 10-cent tour.
Okay! This is more than a senior moment.
I thought her boyfriend was Robert.
He is.
Where is he?
Upstairs.
Well, who's that?
Harper.
Who's he?
Her boyfriend.
Of course. How silly of me. Got it.
You keep the kids out of harm's way. And if need be, you throw yourself in harm's way.
And this little piggy went wee, 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 all the way home.
Wait. Thanks.
Thank you, Sam.
Bye, ladies.
What's that kid's story?
He's an Eastland student. I hired him myself.
Why?
He's on scholarship.
Okay, ladies. I believe we are sufficiently dried. Feel free to show these off amongst your friends.
Aunt Blair, how come you don't have kids?
Oh, please, I have enough crow's feet already, thank you. Besides, stretch marks are so permanent. Oh, enough about that. Your room is across the hall. You have your own bathroom, which I have stocked with mousses, masks, and makeup.
I don't wear makeup.
I do.
Jamie, darling, just because your mom prefers Penn's oil to baby oil, does it mean you have to miss out on all the fun?
I'm going to see if Sam wants to play some touch football.
But you'll mess up your nails. There's a ping pong table in the basement.
This is Tad. Leave a message.
Hey, baby, it's me. I hope you're getting things all wrapped up at work. Call me back soon. You're not going to believe what's going on with Natalie. Love you. Bye.
This place is fantastic, isn't it?
If you think size counts. I could never live here, though.
No? Where would you rather live?
Oh, I could live in a grass hut if you would live there with me.
Easy, Tarzan. If we lived in a grass hut, where would I plug in my computer?
Tarzan will get you extension cord.
Tarzan, get you broadband connection. Tarzan hunt and fish while Natalie produce Emmy award-winning segments. No, tell Jane. Jane have very good lawyer. Take everything from Tarzan. Tarzan left with only loincloth. Only see cheetah on weekends.
You know what? Don't move. I want you to stay right there. Stay right there.
Where are you
I'm
going?
I'm gonna get my camera. Stay right there. Don't move it.
Wait. Ah, no.
No.
Harper.
You're.
Hi. Hey. I feel so much better. I think I'm just gonna take a little stroll around the gardens, and then we can have some dinner here.
Oh, you don't want to eat here, Robert. The food is awful. Lee, French. It's very French. It's very French.
I love French food.
But I really think Tootie really wanted to show you beautiful downtown Peekskill, didn't you, Tootie? I mean, Dorothy.
Yes, absolutely.
So what was Nat like as a teenager?
How much time have you got?
Hey. Hey, let's go see the pool.
Can we see it?
Ew, what is that? It's a riff I wrote inspired by Jimi Hendrix. He's a god.
It sounds like somebody's dying.
Whatever. You probably like Destiny's Child.
At least you can dance to it.
Hi. Compliments of Mrs. Warner. And Sam, your bell captain. Hey, cool. I play the drums.
Should I care?
No, I just thought maybe we should jam sometime. That's all. Hey, you want to go into town? Shoot some pool or something?
Is there a bowling alley in town?
Yeah, there's a bowling alley. So, you guys in?
I'm in. Yeah, all right.
Great. I'll catch you at the end of my shift.
What exactly do you do at Lincoln Center?
I'm a fundraiser. Theater couldn't survive without a dedicated subscription base.
Patrons, corporate sponsors.
Don't remind me, please. Do you know that they're actually considering putting a restaurant on the roof just to subsidize next season?
Yeah, well, you know, the show must go on.
A noble tradition.
I miss the theater so much.
But you're an actress, I thought.
Well, that depends on your definition of actress. Hosting Wake Up with Dorothy is not exactly Brecht.
But let me tell you something. If I had to be subjected to Brecht first thing every morning, I'd never get out of bed.
Well, I barely manage it myself. I mean, I'm up at 4:30 every morning, in bed by 9. Doesn't leave much room for a personal life. I can't remember the last time I saw a play, much less acted in one. Oh, no! Oh, man, I don't believe it.
Looks like there's a shortage of corporate sponsors in Peekskill, too.
I had my first paid acting gig in here.
No kidding. What was it?
The Wild Duck.
The Wild Duck? Oh, you know, that play has the power to reduce me to tears. I love that play. Because right now it's just making me hungry.
Come on. There's a really good Italian restaurant across the street.
All right.
This place has such good food. Oh, man.
Oh, well, it's no big deal. Let's go back to the hotel and find Nat. I'm in the mood for French anyway.
Come on.
Okay.
We're back!
Ow.
We?
It's an old habit. Hosting a talk show every day. You know, when you come back from commercial, you go, "Hi, we're back." Even when it's just me, like now, it's just me.
All right.
Blair, you're here, and I'm here, and Harper's here, and Tootie's back.
Oh, well, the Harper. Let me show you our apiary.
Okay.
I need 5 minutes to have a nervous breakdown.
Where's Mrs. G?
Natalie, you can't.
I thought we were hitting it off rather famously.
You know what?
I suffer from panic attacks. Okay. Crazy.
Go on.
An eighth of an inch into the lug nut.
Excuse me, do you have a fax for me?
Yeah.
Thank you. Can I use the phone, please?
Yeah. Thank you.
Excuse me, there is a sconce strobing in the bar.
Well, of course there is.
It is making my wife nauseous.
Well, of course it is, and I will fix it.
Hi, Steve. Yeah, it's Robert. Yes, I am still in the country. Listen, I just wanted to respond to your memo. I've been giving a great deal of thought to the restaurant. Yeah, and you know I'm not predisposed to liking the idea, but I am keeping an open mind. No, you'll receive my full evaluation by next week.
Yes.
Right. Yes, it is a dark day for the theater. Well, cheers.
Mon Dieu, he comes tonight!
Ooh, who comes tonight?
The reviewer is here! This is a disaster!
These disasters seem to be going around.
This is chaos. We need a plan.
I say you tell them you were working me too hard.
They're both so wonderful.
Natalie, only one guy can win first prize.
Mm-hmm. And one guy gets the booby prize.
I'll have it figured out by morning.
You got a plan?
Well, we just have to monitor them. I mean, they can't be running around willy-nilly.
Right. We need to keep an eye on both of them at all times.
Well, look, it's not like they can get lost, you guys. The place ain't that big.
Excusez-moi? Palatial Properties Digest just named us most spacious inn.
Point being, we need to use every inch of it and keep them apart.
I think it would be much easier if you just fessed up.
Dorothy's right. Natalie, you just need to sit them down, look them both in the eyes, and simply explain to Harper that you're choosing Robert because his portfolio is more diversified.
Okay, Harper's in his room, catching up on his box scores on my laptop.
Thank you, Mrs. Garrett. That will keep him occupied. But what's the plan for dinner?
I just had another one of my brilliant ideas. This is a piece of cake. You know, in 1982, I kept 7 boys online at the Junior League Cotillion. Now, Dorothy, at 7 o'clock, you'll have drinks in the bar with Harper while Natalie and I have a quick bite with Robert in the dining room. Then, you and Harper can have dinner at 8:15 and Natalie will join you guys.
What about the kids? Mrs. Garrett, can you watch them?
I'd be glad to. I wouldn't want them getting whiplash trying to follow the action.
If Harper asks where I am, you say I had a migraine and that Natalie's taking care of me. If Robert asks where you are, we say you have a migraine and Natalie's going to check on you after dinner.
Gee, what could possibly go wrong? Bonsoir, Monsieur Gauguin.
Salut. I'm making the finest cassoulet. L'écaille avec framboise and crème brûlée.
Mmm, oh la la. And I am making les cookies du chocolat chip for the little girl.
Just stay out of my way.
Pardon.
This is a very important night. There's something wrong with the ceviche.
Maybe a little coriander.
Coriander? Barbaric.
That'll cut the lemon.
But where is my... Oh, sacré bleu, I sent it back.
Oh, I brought some for my stuffing.
Help yourself.
Who knew a commoner such as this would possess such a fine palette?
Imagine a mere commoner.
Nat is always raving about you two. I mean, Dorothy. But it's great to finally get together with
you. Yeah, no, it's going to be a really great hour and a quarter.
Right. So are Nat and Blair gonna join us here?
No. Blair has a migraine and Natalie is keeping her company.
The Queen and the Prince of Wales.
Robert, what a wonderful raconteur you are.
Thank you, Blair. Sweetheart? You okay? You look a little distracted.
No, I'm great.
Oh, good.
And after we made it through the jungles of Thailand, we knew we could withstand pretty much anything. Aww. Even the landmines of dating.
Well, dating certainly has its landmines.
Oh, yeah. Would you excuse me, please? I gotta go to the men's room.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do.
Okay. It's right outside. To the left, across from the desk.
Okay.
Dining room.
Monsieur, permit me, with my compliments, please accept a special amuse-bouche.
Sweetheart? Blair?
French, makes her woozy. It was always her worst subject in school. Momentito. Natalie, come back. He's gone. Are you sure?
Yes.
Excuse me. 1 minute.
Sweetheart.
Monsieur, please.
What are you doing? You're supposed to be watching him.
I was watching him. He escaped.
I'm having heart palpitations in there. He's using the dining room bathroom. Stick to the plan.
I am. Hi, there you are.
Did you miss me?
Oh, more than you know. Now tell me, how do you stay cool under pressure? Because I could sure use some pointers.
Flow. Float. Floating.
Yeah, you're the best in the street.
Yeah, well, I've still got 1 or 2,000 recipes, didn't they?
Why is everyone making such a fuss over Aunt Nat dating two guys?
Well, she's just surprised to see them both here at the same time. That's all.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing in my book. I think it's fine to play the field. Just as long as you don't try to pitch and hit at the same time.
Little Lynn, good evening.
Night, Mrs. G. See you tomorrow.
Don't stay up too late.
We won't.
Good
night.
Hey, partner. Your chariot awaits.
Right foot, left foot, John Wayne.
I'm ready when you are, dude. Let's hit it.
It's all again there.
I look like a buster to you?
When?
And Blair gave you permission to take this into town?
Town's maybe 5 blocks away.
That's like a mile in LA.
About things like who was the first person who put ketchup on french fries?
No. You know, I've got a great idea.
What?
You want to get some dinner?
No. I wouldn't mind another drink.
No, I have another drink. I'm going to be singing God Save the Queen in Spanish.
Monsieur is not partial to this squash au gratin.
Oh, after 5 courses, my taste buds are numb.
We gotta go. I know Harper is crazy hungry.
Leave it to me.
Chef, merci beaucoup. The dinner was magnifique. Oh. But now we must go and check on an ailing friend.
I'm starving. I gotta eat.
But you have not had the cheese plate and dessert.
Let me go find that.
Go, Gail, go.
Dinner is
finished.
Robert, shall we?
Harper, wait!
Hey, sweet boy. Let's go upstairs.
Sweetie, I am starving.
Let's do room service.
Thank you.
Madame does not understand.
No, please.
Dinner is very important.
Let go of me. Goodness gracious.
You all right?
I think I've broken out.
Oh, la la. I am finished.
Why don't you stay here and get comfortable, and I'll go to the kitchen and get you something to eat.
Wouldn't it be nicer if we just let someone...
No, I want to feed you something scrumptious, and then You can feed me.
Fierce.
Yeah. Ooh, ooh, ooh,
ooh. Robert! Oh, hi!
Hi. You know, I think I made an awful mistake intruding on your reunion.
Oh, no, it's not that.
Nat, you're wonderful, and I am crazy about you, but... Well, I'm sensing that I'm making you uncomfortable. So I'm going to go back to the city in the morning, and I'll call you on the weekend, all right?
Don't forget to call me.
I won't forget.
I cannot believe we actually got away with it.
The perfect crime. Oh.
No! Sorry.
Hello.
Hi.
I know there's no precipitation in the forecast, but it appears to be raining in my room.
Oh, the pipe.
Evidently.
Hmm.
Do you think I could get another room?
Oh, yeah, there's one left.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Thank you.
Good night. Good night.
Sadly, yes.
Mr. Plaid PJs here says he's in Peekskill to see you. I told him he must have the wrong Natalie.
Ladies, I've got some bad news.
Well, let me guess. You're here to see Natalie, too.
No, the kids have been arrested.
What?
Jamie and Tisha and Sam, the bellboy, broke into Eastland. The cops noticed Mrs. Warner's Mercedes and got suspicious.
Are they all right?
Oh, yeah, sure.
What about the car?
Well, that's funny. I didn't think to ask.
Well, we must find out.
Yes, let's go.
Not you.
Hello. We're here to pick up the kids.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the old teenage reprobates with a drinking problem.
What?
It was the fall of 1982. 9 p.m. Wednesday evening, underage drinking. One night in the can and community service.
How do you remember that?
Why do you remember that?
Well, I've been the Peekskill Police Department desk clerk for the last 25 years. And I take my ginkgo biloba, too, so don't try any funny stuff. Now, let me guess, these juvenile delinquents in the back must be yours.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Ned, could you bring those kids out here to me, please?
Right away, sir.
So where's your partner, the mouthy one?
Los Angeles.
Mommy, it was so scary. They searched us and took away all our stuff.
Yeah, I want my Swiss Army knife back.
Well, forget it. Concealed weapon.
And my cell phone.
Uh-uh, that's a concealed weapon, too. That phone bill is a killer.
Officer, I'm sure these kids were just curious. We have been talking so much about Eastland lately.
Okay. Come on. Okay? You're not really going to press charges, right? They didn't break anything. You didn't break anything, did you?
Well, when you girls were arrested, we weren't so lenient.
Mommy, you were arrested, too?
It was nothing.
No, it wasn't nothing. It was something, I'll tell you.
Oh, Holly, officer, thank you so much for your help. We have to be going. Thank you, though.
And I had so hoped you girls would break the vicious cycle of crime.
And I'm going to spend the rest of my days here, at the Little Inn. A lonely, broken-hearted recluse.
Oh, that's so romantic. It's like Miss Havisham in Great Expectations, jilted by her betrothed on her wedding day. She spends the rest of her days in a decaying mansion, still wearing her bridal gown.
Keep the focus on the patient, okay?
Sorry.
I can't believe Nat would do this to me.
To you?
I think I'm the more aggrieved party here.
How's that?
Natalie made several allusions to us having a future together.
That's funny, because Nat and I, we always lived in the ecstatic moment.
Well, she told me that I was the only man she'd ever met who used 380 thread count bed linens.
Well, she certainly didn't seem to mind the night we spent on a bed of straw in East Timor.
Where are you going?
I am going to forgive Natalie for what was obviously a meaningless indiscretion.
Whoa. Hang on, bed linens.
You think she'd choose you over me?
Look, an intelligent, sensible woman like Natalie is going to opt for a successful, stable man like myself, not some reckless, unfocused punk like you.
You think?
I know.
Okay. Well, let's play this out. We go back to the hotel and propose a competition. No. Nat sets the ground rules and we abide by her decision.
May the best man win.
And the best man win.
Little Ann. Oh, please hold.
Raymond? Money is no object. I don't care if you have to call every plumber in the state of New York. I want that pipe fixed.
All right. You know, yellow was never your color. All right, I'll fix it. I'm on it, Ms. WW. Watch me. I'm going.
Hi, sweetie. So when am I going to get to show off this fabulous husband of mine? Honey, no. You said that would be finished today. Tomorrow is Wednesday. You know how terrible traffic will be. This was supposed to be a vacation for us, too. No, that's okay. I understand. I'm just disappointed. Hold on, Bonnie and Clyde. Just get here as fast as you can. I love you, too.
Come on, Mrs. Warner. We said we were sorry last night.
You two come with me. I have someone I want you to talk to. What? Chef, have you seen Mrs. G?
No, MSG.
What?
Oh, no, not MSG. Mrs. G. That's me. I was just looking for a French chef on the web to give me a new recipe for yam glaze.
Mrs. Garrett, you insult me going to your French chef on the top of the lap. You have your own French chef right here, ici. Gauguin will glaze your yams.
Mrs. Garrett, could I please talk with you for a moment?
Oh, of course.
Mrs. Garrett, I need you to talk to Jamie and Sam. Mm. Last night's shenanigans were completely unacceptable.
So tell him.
Mrs. Garrett, that's your job.
Sweetie, I'm retired. You girls were my last gig.
But,
darling, just try what I tried. Trust that little inner voice you got. The words will fall out right.
No, you don't understand. I am not any good with kids. What would I say? Stealing cars is bad. Breaking and entering is bad. But more importantly, those things are just wrong. I think someone famous once said,
Thou shalt not steal? When I was at Eastland, my cousin Jerry came to visit me, and I was really embarrassed.
Why?
Because Jerry has cerebral palsy. I was afraid that people would associate Jerry's disability with me. But then it hit me. People really liked Jerry. They adored her.
Why'd everyone like her so much?
Because she was very funny and very sweet. But mostly, I think it was just because Jerry had a way of making people feel comfortable just by being herself. You know, sometimes I think the best way to fit in or be cool is just be exactly who you are.
I get it, Aunt Blair. Would you be cool enough not to tell my mom?
Next time we'll go bowling.
And I'll drive.
Oh, hey! What are you doing out here by yourself?
Aunt Blair's reading Sam and Jamie the Riot Act, so I thought it'd be a good time to take a walk.
Oh, did you? Well, you're about to get read your own riot act, Miss Girl. Why didn't you tell me that you wanted to go into town? I would have taken you myself. But going with Sam? Taking Blair's car? Maybe that's just stupid. I'm here for you, okay? I want you to talk to me, honey. I need you to feel comfortable letting me know what you're thinking.
I'm thinking you're never home.
Well, I work crazy hours so that we can live comfortably, so that you can go to a good school.
So you can forget Daddy died?
So that I can forget how much I miss him.
You still miss him?
All the time. Sweetie, I loved your daddy since I was 16. He was the love of my life.
Why don't you talk about him? Why don't we have pictures of him in the house?
Because I didn't want to upset you.
I'm starting to forget what he looked like.
Come here. Come here. Ah, yeah. You know, your daddy loved you so much. How he used to call you his little love bucket. You were the most important person in the whole world to him.
He loved you too.
He loved us both very much. And he would want us to be happy.
I'm not happy about my school. I hate it.
You do?
The girls are all cliquey and catty and show-offs. I don't have real friends like you did at Eastland.
I'm gonna figure this out. For both of us. Here. I want you to have this.
Thank you, Mommy.
You're welcome.
Hello? Darling, hi. Hi, Blair. I am so proud of myself. I
can't talk now. I've got an emergency.
Where are you? What kind of emergency?
I'll call you later.
Ted? Ted?
Oh, that chef cook has a frisky one. When I say no, he says wee.
You know, I don't know which is worse, trying to juggle two or hold on to one.
Oh,
Hey, guys, it is gorgeous outside.
Do you think it'll snow?
Honey, it's 60 degrees.
Isn't global warming delightful?
No snow angels or snowmen or igloos?
Yeah, but you don't have to shovel the driveway or the terrace or the roof.
Okay. Oh, that's enough.
Hey, that's my mother.
Looks like we have company.
What now, Locust?
It's your boyfriend.
Oh.
And your other boyfriend.
And of course, the last three categories in the competition are fitness, dancing, and listening. Have I forgotten anything?
Sense of humor.
Humor.
Most important one.
I am all over that.
Here, I thought you girls could use some sandwiches. How you doing, kid?
Never better.
Oh, well, now, let's see. Political awareness, cultural literacy, shoe shopping?
I asked for that one.
Of course. Finances, parenting skills, romance.
This is nuts. No one chooses someone because of a pageant list.
Mm. Amen, sister. You guys, this is such puerile, Peter Pan, type A, alpha male, boys will be boys, get booked on my talk show behavior.
Well, it is. Lest we forget, they wanted it. So here's what I say. If they're gonna be men and act like, well, men, then we might as well enjoy the show. Right? Okay, Dorothy and I will judge them and give you the scores immediately following.
Why me?
Because you're the scorekeeper.
Oh, Raymond, my son, the CPA, can do it.
What? And give up plumbing?
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, I understand you girls used to live in Mrs. Garrett's attic. I guess you could say that you lived in Mrs. Garrett's garret.
A lot of people are wondering whether Natalie and I are in the Mile High Club. I can't tell you that I'm sure because Bosnia Air uses the metric system. Good night, thank you.
What's the Mile High Club?
Oh, it's an organization of frequent flyers.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful 100%.
Come live with me and be my love, and we will some new pleasures prove of golden sands and crystal brooks, with silken lines and silver hooks.
Yeah!
Those are the ones.
Oh, no.
Not boo.
Oh, boo.
Yes. So then Miss Girl Veronica told me that Wendy told her that Christina's boyfriend had seen that Jenna was talking trash about me. And I was like,
how long
no
have you been in the decorating business?
Like a Louis Cador's love seat with La Caboussier chairs?
You
are you insane?
And which is why I think Caravaggio truly exemplifies the rebelliousness of the late Renaissance.
When I'm on the John, that's when I catch up on most of my reading. My Garfield, my Beetle Bailey, and Charlie Brown, which is always a good one.
Of course, my financial plan is to maintain a balanced portfolio of stocks and bonds.
And I pretty much spend the rest on Brady Bunch memorabilia. I actually have Marsha's original hairbrush, which is kind of cool.
Gentlemen, we're ready for you.
Hey, Ronnie, I think you left your chest upstairs there, brother.
That's very funny. Howdy doody wants his brain back.
Okay, Raymond!
Come on, what are we doing? This was a ridiculous idea. I'm out of here.
I'm history.
Unless you have a noose or razor blades or a very strong cup of coffee, please go away.
Well, I can't help you with instruments of self-destruction, but Java I got.
Thank you. Are they both gone?
Yep. Checked out.
I'm sure they can't wait to get out of Peekskill and away from me.
And they're idiots.
They're two of the greatest idiots I ever met.
Hello?
I'm sorry. I must have the wrong number.
Phone?
Who is this?
This is Maggie. Who's this?
I come bearing cocoa.
Thank you, Mrs. Garrett.
It's the only way I could escape from Coquin. This vacation gives new meaning to the term French resistance. What's wrong?
I think I'm losing him.
You know, I just had a deja vu. Sitting in an Eastland dorm with a young romantic girl who always thought of the perfect marriage.
I remember.
But Blair, really, no marriage is perfect, is it?
I don't know. Maybe this is normal after 10 years. Lately, he's been away on business a lot. And these weird emergencies have come up. But we would never not be together on a holiday. Mm-hmm. And now I've got this sick feeling that... I'm not even gonna say it.
Well, maybe that's part of the problem. You don't say it. You've stopped communicating.
No, I've watched my mother go through this. I can read the writing on the wall.
Oh, Blair, stop jumping to conclusions. Well, just tell him what you're feeling and then see what the writing on the wall says. Now, you and Tad have had a good marriage, right?
I thought we had a great marriage.
Does that mean it couldn't get better?
Mrs. Garrett, is there such a thing as too late?
I'm not going to sugarcoat it. Relationships change as the people in them grow. And if they don't share with each other, it might end. But I don't think it's over yet.
Man, who knew it would still be so hard?
Not me.
Me neither.
You take the good, you take the bad.
We have a lot.
I really have a lot.
We have each other.
Here, here.
Okay, girls. Our scorekeeper asked me to pull to the results, and I want to get the bad taste out of my mouth as soon as possible.
Yeah, right. Okay, who won?
Well, after some state-of-the-art number crunching, the winner is...
Robert.
Wow. I thought it was going to be Harper.
Is that what you really call him?
Yeah. It was.
Well, if you thought he would win, it's because you wanted him to win. There's your answer, my darling. What you wanted in your heart of hearts.
Well, it doesn't matter anymore. They're gone. It's over.
I'm going.
What?
Why? I'm going home. He may be a lying, cheating scoundrel, but he's my lying, cheating scoundrel. And I'm not gonna let him go without a fight.
Atta girl.
Davis, I'll drive myself on this one.
Here, hold up yourself.
Claire, wait! Honey, don't go by yourself. Mrs. Garrett's gonna watch the kids. We're going with you.
In case we got to give him a beat down.
Get in.
Okay, where are we going?
Hotel, I guess. He could be anywhere, little snake. Where do people normally philander?
Hotels.
Okay, let's do this right. When did he call you last?
3 hours ago.
On your cell?
I think so.
Give me your phone. Here. We're gonna check your last incoming calls. Who's that?
Hairdresser.
That?
Electrologist.
How about that?
I have no idea.
Leave this to me. Hi, where are you located, please? Great. And is Tad Warner there? No, don't get him. I'm meeting him, and I just wanted to make sure I had the correct address. Thank you. What?
You're good.
How do you think I found Salman Rushdie? Okay, 7th Street off Avenue B. A place called Korchak House. Harp? Oh, hi, Peter, what's up? You're kidding. But Thursday's Thanksgiving. I know they don't celebrate Thanksgiving in Pakistan, but we do. Yeah. No, you're right. Okay. I'll be on the first plane out Thursday morning. No, Harper's not with me. Can't we get someone else? Okay, I'll try and find him. Guess he's flying to Pakistan Thursday.
Thursday is Thanksgiving.
I know.
You can't delay it one day.
Where are you taking me, Ted?
I don't think it's a hotel.
I don't think it's a brothel either.
Whatever it is, I'm going in.
Well, we're going right with you.
No. Thank you. I need to do this on my own.
Are you sure?
Positive. You take the car and go find Harper. Oh, Natalie. Don't forget who you wanted to win.
Excuse me, I'm looking for a Maggie.
I'm Maggie.
Well, hello, Maggie. I'm Blair Warner Warner. You must be the low-rent, off-the-rack bargain basement tart who's trying to flush 10 years of my marriage down the tube. So this cheap, tawdry affair is the way Ted repays me after I stick by him during the lean times. Okay, so there weren't any lean times. Nevertheless, I stuck by him.
Blair.
I can't believe after all we've been through...
Blair!
What?
Before you go on, there's something I want you to see.
Hang on tight. Coming in for a landing.
Tad!
Blair.
Tad, what is going on here?
Oh, gosh. This is Maggie Rhodes. She's the executive director here at the shelter. They take care of abused, abandoned, and neglected kids.
They what?
They shelter kids.
She answered your phone, Tad.
I've been meaning to tell you. I've been helping them out.
Mr. Tad, could we still play Pin the Tail on the Donkey?
Absolutely, Benji. Just give me a few minutes, okay?
Okay.
He was the emergency.
Damn it, Blair. I've wanted kids for a long time now. And you've made it perfectly clear that you have absolutely no interest in children.
I have?
Let's get you two to a corner where you can talk.
You know, that really is a very lovely blouse.
Now,
If you were a Harper, where would you be?
Why don't you just call him?
We told the network he was turning off his phone and going on vacation.
He turned off his cell phone?
I know. He's a wild man. Oh my God, I got it!
What?
When Harper gets depressed, and I'm not saying he has any reason to be depressed or anything, but when he feels the need to get away from it all, he flies.
Flies?
Yeah, he just charges a plane and takes off. He likes the peace and quiet. Go get him back. For luck. For luck. I love you, Dorothy. Tootie loves you, too. Voicemail. It's me. I know your phone is turned off and you're not gonna get this till you land. But do you see me trying to flag you down like a crazy person? Harper, I love you. Please. Please give me another chance. Hello?
You ran like that for me.
It wasn't for the honey peanuts.
You look so sad.
Well, I am. I mean... Wait. How do you know what I look like?
I couldn't leave. I'm only gonna ask you this once. Natalie Sage Green, will you marry me?
Yes. Yes, I will. after we get back from Pakistan.
What?
We leave Thursday.
I'm yours.
I don't think so.
I misled you.
I stopped talking to you.
We stopped talking to each other.
Yeah.
Blair, I want us to have a baby.
What if I want more than one?
One, two, ten.
We'll have some, we'll adopt some. We're rich, we can afford it. You don't think it's too late?
Not if we start tonight.
Spend Thanksgiving without you guys.
You can't expect Mrs. Garrett to move Thanksgiving up a day. I mean, those things take forever to prepare.
Mrs. G can do anything.
Can you watch our show?
What's the matter, Ma? You can't sleep?
I must be a little worried about the girls.
You want me to make you some warm milk?
Oh, thank you, Raimi. No, I'll go myself.
Little Ann. Oh, hey, Tootie. Oh, okay, I'm sorry, I forgot. Ma, it's Dorothy.
Thank you.
Dorothy, what's going on? What? Harper's where? Blair's what? Thanksgiving's when?
Sure, no problem.
Natalie and Harper are engaged. Blair and Tad are coming back for a second honeymoon. And Thanksgiving is tomorrow.
No, tomorrow's Wednesday.
Don't remind me!
We'll help you, Mrs. G.
Yeah, how hard can it be?
Sure, how hard can it be?
Thank you, Gauguin. You're an artiste.
Oh, Edna, you flatter me. You are not only my esteemed colleague, but I would like to consider you mon petit chou.
I think he just called her a cabbage.
Hey, Jamie,
Daddy.
How you doing?
How are you, sweetie? Oh, I miss you. How are you?
Oh, I'm good. If you came tomorrow, you completely miss Thanksgiving.
Well, why is that, Cupcake?
It was a whole big thing.
What is this place, Mom?
Nothing much. Just the place where I discovered who I wanted to be when I grew up. This theater is where I did my first play and fell in love with acting.
Open. So this Ibsen was a heavy dude, huh?
The heaviest.
I like it here.
You do?
Yeah.
You know what? Come here. I think you would look so pretty in an Eastland uniform.
You think so?
Yeah. Hey, what do you think about me and you moving to New York? I mean, I want to do more theater, and at Eastland, I think you might make some better friends. I mean, some friends that you actually like.
You mean it? Really?
Yeah, really.
Can I go back to the hotel and tell Jamie?
Yeah. Be careful. I've decided that I'm gonna do that play in New York. And a lot of plays after that. Hey, no, I don't need to think about it. I've already thought about it. And I'm not going to renew my contract. Happy Thanksgiving.
Congratulations. The theater is proud to have you back, Ms. Ramsey.
What are you doing here?
I got back to the city, and I couldn't get this place out of my mind. Regional theaters. They should be treasured. And I was also thinking that if I had the right partner, a beautiful old place like this could get resurrected.
I was thinking exactly the same thing.
Partner.
Partner.
Yeah. I think that'll be a good thing to start with, don't you?
Absolutely.
Oh, Dorothy, I.
Robert.
I'm Mrs. Garrett. Oh, hey, no, don't worry. I've talked to Natalie, and everything's great between us.
Oh. Wunderbar. Come on. Follow me.
Let's go.
Excuse me. I have a reservation for this evening. Can you point me to the restaurant?
I'm sorry, madam. There's been a change of plans. The restaurant is closed. We're serving dinner at a local preparatory school.
Really? Why is that?
We like eating off of trays. Come along, why don't you join the celebration? By the way, today is Thanksgiving.
Whatever you say, Miles Standish.
No. Due to the nature of my work, I generally prefer to eat alone. Do you mind?
No, we could set something up.
Yeah, perfect.
I'd like to make a toast. All of us who attended Eastland know that we had something very special. We cared about each other. And while you guys were learning in the classroom, I was learning from you. It wasn't easy for me to leave everything familiar, get married, join the Peace Corps. But the things I learned here at Eastland got me through a lot of unexpected twists and turns through the years. And so I want to say thank you to my girls, to Blair, for her loyalty to her friends and her devotion to Tad, to Tootie.
Oh, no.
Surrender, Dawson. To Tootie, for her commitment to her two passions, her wonderful daughter, and the theater. And to Joe, for approaching life not only with guts, but gusto, and for always having the courage to go for it. And to Natalie, for her amazing sense of humor, through good times and not so good, and for her endless compassion for others. To all of us, to many more reunions, and to peace on earth. Happy Thanksgiving!
That reviewer from Gourmet just left. She said she loved the food and was going to give the restaurant a great write-up.
The reviewer is right over there.
No. She came tonight. Sat over there. She said this place defined the resurgence of haute American home cooking.
American home cooking? Oh, I will be a laughing stock in Paris.
In Paris, perhaps. But in Peekskill, you'll be a star.
Yes, Chef. Maybe we should try to coax Mrs. Garrett to come to the inn to work with you.
Oh, this I would love.
I came as soon as I got your message.
Oh, Captain, my Captain.
Ooh, there's gonna be trouble.